Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And during a recent live stream, someone asked us the question, how do I get the values out of the between slicer or the before slicer or the after slicer? Well, in this video, guess what? I'm going to show you. Stay tuned. Find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, on a live stream, someone said, hey, I'm using that between slicer, I'm using the before slicer or the after slicer. How do I get the values out of those text boxes? And I was like, I don't have time to go and work up a demo, but I'm gonna do a video to show you. And here we are, here's the video. So enough of all this talking, let's head over to my laptop. Okay, very simple report. It's got a date and a sales amount. We grab the slicer visual, and we drop the date in it, and I wanna know how to get that value and that value out of it. Or if I move it like this, I wanna get that value. So this is what you wanna do. You wanna go to View, turn on Performance Analyzer, click Start Recording, and then I'm just gonna refresh this element. Watch that. I'm gonna do this, copy paste, head over to DAX Studio and paste it in there. And you can see all DAX Studio does, it grabs the min and the max from each one. So I decided I'm just gonna take these exact expressions for each the min and the max. I'm gonna take this one, go back here, create a new measure. I'm gonna call it min date. I'm gonna paste it in. And then I'm gonna go back to DAX Studio and I'm gonna grab the max one and I'm gonna paste it in. So we're gonna go right here, max date, paste it in. So now I have the min and max date. And now if I drop two cards on the screen, two card visuals on my report, and then I'm gonna drop the max date, the bottom one, and the min date in the top one. And now, if I move this one, the minimum will change. And if I move that one changes, which is great. But what about the before and the after? So if you go over here, choose slicer settings, so I'm gonna switch it from between to before. Now think about this, before. So I want everything that's before this date. So I have a list of dates up until this point, and I want everything before that. So what do I need? I need the max, I need the maximum date because it's gonna be the last date in that list. But if I want everything after, all the dates afterwards, that's gonna be the min date. So now I can grab the minimum for the after and the maximum before. Let me show you. I set this to before, the maximum should change. If I move this out, see how it goes to 426. If I move this in, it goes to 416. If I switch this to after, and start moving it about, the minimum's gonna change. So you see how it changes to 4.7, and if I move it back, it changes to 8.4. So for after, you would use the min date, for before, you use the max date. I got a little fancy, and I created these dynamic labels. So since we're set for after right now, we wanna make a dynamic label for this. So if we click here, you can see I said after all sales, I put before all sales, after a particular date. So now I'm gonna drag this onto the design surface, to the report canvas, and make a card. And so you can see everything after 8.4. So if I start moving it back and forth, you'll see how it dynamically changed based on that selection. Now, if I switch my slicer to before, let's go to slicer settings, change this to before. And now if I move this back and forth, right, the minimum just goes to that minimum date that I have, but nothing else changes. But if I change this to my before, so look at the DAX, right? All sales max, remember, because after I chose min, but before I choose max, I'm gonna drop this over here. And now if I move my slicer about, it dynamically changes that value. And then for between, so if I switch this slicer setting to between, and I change this to between, so let's take a peek at the DAX, all sales from the min date to the max date. And I'm just formatting it because I want it to show a particular way. But if I move either one, they'll adjust. My label will be dynamic and adjust to what you see right there. All right, what do you think? It was actually easier than I thought. I thought about using values, getting the max minimum, iterating through it, all these different things, but it was much easier just by using a little performance analyzer to answer that question for me. All right, what do you think? Have you solved this a different way? Are you using this method? Do you have a better method? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button, like my video. Big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.